Okay, our first guest has been described as the David Beckham of the classical music world. At just 26, he regularly sells out venues across the globe and has attracted a fan base as keen on his sensational talent as his Playboy persona. Reflecting the tastes of the MTV generation, his latest album, Virtuoso, has shot up the charts in its first week of release, and here's why. Please welcome David Garrett.
Hello.
Hello.
That's perked all the girls up.
I like that.
We're all interested in classical music.
Yeah.
Well, I think that was brilliant, actually. Didn't you teach yourself?
Well, I had my dad who kind of like played a little bit the violin. He gave me the first couple of lessons. And then, of course, regular teachers for many, many years.
Is this the violin that you fell on and crushed?
Unfortunately not. It's still being repaired in New York. And I have two, it's kind of like a blessing in disguise. So many people have been like coming forward and offering me wonderful Stradivarius, and I've just been
really, very
lucky.
Yeah.
It was quite an expensive violin you fell on.
Very expensive.
Right?
It was my own, which really made it even worse.
It was like, almost priceless, apparently.
How expensive? Yeah, can we be nosy? Because we don't know
of
how.
Of course
expensive.
You can be nosy.
Yeah, turn around this way now.
All right, I'm turning. No, my own violin was about $1 million, which is like a lot of money.
No!
But,
why are they so expensive? Because they're old.
They're very old. They're like, the sound is perfect. Like, they have wonderful warmth, wonderful quality.
And how did you...
They're very rare
you,
also.
How did you come to... fall on it? You went out with Carol or something the night before?
Well, funnily enough, it was at the Barbican Centre here in London. I just kind of slipped down the stairs after the concert. It wasn't the case, but, you know, I fell with my whole body weight on it.
And nobody cared about you, just about the prices.
No, actually, funnily enough, everybody was like, are you all right? And the first thing I said is the violin all right?
Is the violin okay? Well, we can't have you come on here and not play us a tune.
Exactly.
Would you mind playing something?
Well, I heard you might want to hear the Bumblebee, which
oh, yeah,
is, of course, a fast,
fab.
Speedy one. So I hope you're going to get this one. No family.
That's not what I read here. It says you're a bit of a playboy and you've got a girl in every part you do.
Really? Where did you get that information?
Well, you must have said it, darling. You must have said it. Is that true? You've got women all over the place.
Oh, that sounds terrible, but of course, you know, I travel a lot, so my friends are spread out, of course.
Your friends, yeah.
A lot of cities.
Did you like that bit of culture?
I liked that bit. That was lovely.
Marvellous.
Very impressive. Any chance of you playing something I know?
Well, you might... actually, that's a premiere, actually. I thought about that a little backstage.
Come on, you'll watch
it. Don't
pretend you'll,
you know this one.
Okay. Smooth Criminal, wasn't it,
exactly.
Michael Jackson? And what the amazing thing about your album is you would expect it to do well in classical music albums, but in the mainstream album charts, you're at number 13.
It's amazing. I'm so... it's unbelievable. I don't even know what to say, to be quite honest.
So do you meet kind of, you know, younger kids who are sort of buying your album and then going out and buying the Kaiser Chiefs?
Well,
or...
what happened in Germany, where it was released a couple of months ago, it was also like the same kind of thing happened. A lot of young kids actually went out and bought the CD. And that was kind of the vision I had before doing it, really to kind of try to make a good balance between pieces they know and classical pieces, so they kind of can relate to it, you know, kind of build a bridge for the younger generations. And it kind of worked. It's like a dream come true.
I wonder what the establishment, the sort of the classical music world think of you, because you're a bit of a rebel.
Oh, no, come on. We heard you were kicked out
of the Royal College of Music
well,
in London.
It was a mutual kind of agreement, let's put it like that. You know, the dean didn't want to have me there, and I probably didn't want to be there as well at that point. But I did graduate music school in New York.
Did you?
In Juilliard, yeah.
So that's where you live now?
I was just a little bit of a naughty person.
Were you a rebel?
Certainly didn't listen to many people. And still don't, actually.
Have you met Carol?
Excuse me.
Have you met Carol McGiffin?
I'm not a rebel.
Yes,
I mean, would you give it all up for love?
Would I give it all up for love? I don't know. I haven't found that yet. So are you indicating something?
No, we were just talking about Joss Stone saying that she would, obviously, you know who Joss Stone is. Mm. She would give it all up for love, and she's only 20.
She would give it all up for love. Well, you know, I think it really depends who you meet. I mean, I haven't met the person yet. Probably if I would. I could give you an answer.
Hey, listen,
I'm joking.
Thank you so much for coming to the studio today and for bringing your wonderful music to us. Pleasure to meet you.
Virtuoso's
out now, isn't it?
It is out now in stores, and yeah.
Come back and see us again.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much. David Garrett, everybody. Time for a quick break, but when we return, should you reveal all your deepest secrets to your friends? Back soon.